Have you ever met someone, and as soon as you met them, you knew you liked them, that you felt that you knew them right away? Have you ever had that experience? You meet someone, and you shake their hand, you greet each other, and somehow you just have this feeling, I've known you. You are so close to me, and yet this person should really be a stranger. Well, that happened to me a month ago when I met Bobby Kalotee. We had dinner after one of our conferences, and I thought I had met my long-lost brother. And since that time, Bobby has become a part of Montessori Model United Nations and a supporter for our organization. And he's helped us with bringing delegations to this conference. Bobby is many things. He's a very successful businessman. He is a great humanitarian, and he is the organizer and chairman of the International Friends for Good Health. And his work with Friends of Good Health is he makes friends with people all over the world by bringing together 100 doctors. And 100 doctors visit countries and people in the developing world who would not have any access to medical care. At his last trip, they served over 7,000 people in Central America. In this summer, Bobby will be bringing the doctors to Colombia, Kenya, and Greece, another several thousand people who will receive care who otherwise would not receive it. The motto of his organization is, there is no better gift than good health. I think we can all agree with that. Bobby, would you come up with that?
Good evening, student delegates, teachers, and parents. It's an honor and privilege for me to stand in front of you in this beautiful United Nations Assembly Hall. It's a privilege for all of you who are in attendance also. Please join me to applaud our leader who had worked so hard in MMUN, Montessori Schools, Judith Cunningham and Michael Jefferson. Sometimes it looks easy, but the work they put it in is a lot of hours to organizing from teachers, from schools, from one country to the other country, and other difficulties, including the visas. Michael, even though Judith was talking about me, how we met, and you end up liking someone on the first meeting. It was the other way around. I met Judith. I'm usually a difficult guy, but she being so humble, and she is my sister from that day on. And again, Judith, I'm honored and privileged to call you a sister and a friend and a leader, and thank you. I can make a long speech, a boring speech, or an interesting speech. So let's stay with an interesting speech, because you guys have traveled just like me from other countries. Some are tired, some are hungry. But I see you guys are as excited as I am. On my way, I met Ocean, who's representing France, Bailey, who's representing Canada, and brother, Ocean is already in India trying to learn how to be more peaceful, right? And Charlotte from Mexico. You know, you all delegate, I think, deserve a big hand of applause from the teachers, the parents, and the leaders. Would you please join me today? You know, your parents and your teachers already took a step which I did not have the privilege of. I never went to school except one day. I speak 5 languages fluently, but the most important language I speak, I was sharing with Ocean and the teachers, my new friend from Ireland, since I'm half Irish, is the human language. Once we understand the human language, I think we are very peaceful. The problem is we are running in a race, which I learned from my childhood. My siblings choose very few teachers in school. I choose everyone as my teacher, regardless of what age they was in, if they are my age or they are older than me. I accepted they are my teacher, I can learn something from them. It's up to you. If you believe it, you can do anything that you want. As long as you believe in it, respect your parents, respect yourself, respect your teacher, respect the society. Since you had the privilege to learn so many things here today and next 3 days, remember, with that privilege, you also have a responsibility. A responsibility to go back to the community or the society you come from or the school you come from to share with your friends, with your teachers, your neighbors, what you have learned. You know, not too many people are going to be able to sit here and learn what you are learning. And that is your world. And you can change it, Ocean, any way you want for tomorrow, because you want to be irresponsible for better world and peaceful world. Like my friend Judith said, it doesn't matter what country we come from. We all want to learn something about each other, a little nervous, a little non-nervous. Think about me, the guy who never went to school, and I had to speak here in English. I never had a TV. I never had any privileges, but I had the most privilege. My good parents and all the teachers from my village. Teacher means my neighbors, the entire society. I accepted that. And that responsibility made me to respect myself and do what is right. With that, the boy who hardly spoke English when came to America. I started as a dishwasher, but not too long. The time came, I became a chairman of a 2 university, not even one, a hospital. And my friend sitting here, Numantai, I met him, he was one of the students, and I was one of the speakers in the university, where for me it was just a privilege to be in the university. So the point I'm trying to make is, if you believe in yourself, you respect yourself, respect your parents, even though sometimes you don't like to hear what they try to tell you. Respect your teacher, because you sometimes disagree with them because they've given you too much schoolwork. It's not because they want to punish you by schoolwork. They want to make the best out of you. They want you to learn. They don't want you to fail. So if you learn not to fail, I have 5 kids. They asked me one day, Dad, you are pretty strict. I said, no, I'm not. You should be strict with yourself. So one of my daughters said, what that means? This is, I say, how I practice. I put my 100%, no matter what I do. And if I don't succeed, I have no regrets, because that's all I can do. That's all I could do is put 100%. But if you put 99% and now you fail, maybe that 1% would have the return. As long as you remember to put 100% in school, 100% in your belief, 100% in your teachers, 100% in your parents, and 100% in your society, you will have a better world because you are the one going to be tomorrow's presidents, prime ministers, senators, ambassadors, and possibly to be the United Nations Secretary General. So, with that note, thank you for allowing me this privilege and for listening to me. Hopefully, somewhere you keep that in mind when you are in school. If that guy can do it, I can do it. And you can. You're much smarter than me. You know more than I do. So, God bless you. Have a wonderful evening. Enjoy your stay and learn and go back. Please, with your responsibility, share with your friends and colleagues. I do want to mention, even though he's going to be the next speaker, eventually he's going to come in. Hopefully he will come in. He's a former football player, Jack Brewer, who is not here, is one of board members. I hope he comes and share with you his experience, how he had grown up in the hoods, but became a superstar in football, in education, and a great guy and great humanitarian. Let's keep the good work. Thank you very much. God bless you.